¿Cómo se vaya embarazada? Mi hermano, el papá del niño del pelito parado, estaba yendo a la universidad y me dijo, mira este libro de Rush, que no sé qué. Y me dijo que era muy interesante y era un libro bien gordo. Y como me hacían, iba yo a cada rato al doctor a esperar y aquí y allá, y tenía yo que ir a cada rato. Entonces lo estaba yo leyendo. Y cuando vi que decía Yaisa, y dije, oh, si este niño se va a llamar Yaisa.
It's me, Yoz, also known as Yaisa Lara, and I was born on March 15th, 1989, into a Mexican Guatemalan family in which quinceañeras are a really important part of culture. Being Hispanic, I've always dreamt of the day when I could, you know, wear my beautiful dress, look like the princess that I am, and celebrate with my friends and family this special celebration, like my coming of womanhood. My coming of age. And so I've been planning for it. You know, I've been planning it for about maybe like I think a year. And it's been really hard work. It's been harder than I imagined it would be.
During the practices, like the first practices, it was kind of hard because we hadn't found all of the royal court. We were still missing people here and there. Like, we would ask someone and then they would tell us yes. And then they would say they couldn't be in it anymore, so it was a little hard. Towards the end, you know, we got everyone together.
That one, my royal court, I knew for a really long time. Like, my cousin Alex was in it, and I've grown up with him since I was really little. We started hanging out more recently. Like, after my quinceañera, we just really got to know each other better. His partner was Vanessa, and I met her in my cousin's quinceañera. We shared a lot of friends in common from my school and her school. And she was really cool and really nice, so I wanted her to come out in my quinceañera. And Victor, I met Victor in church. We became really good friends because he's just, like, really outgoing, and he likes to party a lot. He likes to have fun. He knows how to dance really well. And his partner was Danielle, and I also know her through church. I've known her for like 4 years, and we've gotten to know each other. We share a lot of friends in common, and we hang out a lot. I asked my friend Kate, she's like one of my best friends from school, to come out in mine. She's really excited because she's not Hispanic or anything, so she's never been in a quinceañera, she's never been to one. Or her partner was her boyfriend, Daniel. Daniel's really shy, he doesn't talk a lot, so he's really cool. My cousin Jose was in it too. I didn't really know him very well. We started talking to him, and I started talking to him more, and we'd like hang out now. And he came out with my cousin Julie, and me and Julie are close. Like, we went to school together since we were like 5, and we've just like grown together. And one of my other really good friends, Venetia, who's really, really loud. I love her so much. I've known her for 9 years, and we always have fun together. We always laugh together. We always like get in trouble together. And she came out with this guy Jonathan, who I'd heard about him and I'd seen him a couple times. I basically really started getting to know him in my quinceañera, and he's really, really cool. He's really funny. He bugs people a lot though, but that's okay. My friend Patty came out in it too. Patty's like a year older than me, and I've known her for like 2 years, I think, and she's really cool. And she came out with Juan, who I didn't know either at all. He's my cousin's friend. Juan's really outgoing, and he's really fun, and he's always nice to you. And then my guy, Felipe, I've known him since I was little. His sister went to school with me. So he's just a really sweet guy, and I'm glad that he was able to be, you know, my partner for my quinceañera. We'll be right back.
fun, right? I'm having fun, but it's frustrating. It's a lot of frustration for a cousin's love, you know what I mean? But it's all good. I love you, Yos!
You're here, right?
Where's the I'm so strung out. I'm high as a kite. I just might stop to check. When I'm walking, I strive, I stop, and I'm so strung out.
My main chambelan, I was calling him because he hadn't come. He was running a little late, and I called him, and I was like, oh, are you coming to practice today? And he told me, oh, yeah, but I'm only going to go watch because I busted my arm. Like, I was in the desert, and I was driving some little car, and it flipped over, and I was like, oh, my gosh, because during one of the dances, he had to lift me up, and I was like, oh, my gosh, I can't believe this is happening. How are we going to dance? But it wasn't that bad, and it got healed up really quick. Me and my mom, we fought over it. My dad was really not into it. You know, it's just me and my mom. The first fight we had was we were supposed to go look for invitations, and, you know, I had to wake up really early. I didn't want to get up, so my mom left without me. When she came back, she was like, I already got the invitations, and, you know, I already have them printed already, and I'm going to go pick them up tomorrow. And I started crying because I didn't get to choose the invitations, you know. I wanted to do that. And then, like, she was like, I didn't go. I just wanted to scare you to show you, you know. If you don't hurry up, I'm going to do it my way. And that was the first fight we had of many. But the color of the dress was really what we fought over. I already knew what color I wanted it to be, but my mom couldn't really picture it. I wanted it to be sort of Cinderella looking, and that's what it came out with, you know, like, everyone thought it kind of looked like Cinderella, and it went with the place. To me, like, how my dress looked in the place really mattered because the place was like a golden yellow Spanish, so it's like I couldn't walk in with a pink dress or a purple dress or, you know, what some quinceañeras did. So I was like, I want mine to be sort of Spanish looking. And my mom did not have a clue of what I meant, so we fought a little bit over that because she thought it was going to be ugly, but it turned out to be really pretty, so...